Hi, everyone. Living Well Finale starts now.
Well, what a week it's been here. We've been in the backyard every day this week. We've had to move planters that we didn't plan on moving. Of course, projects are always filled with things like that.
For sure. Yeah, but the exciting thing is we have most of our living wall of trees planted. Now, it doesn't look like a wall yet. We're going to be shaping it over the next several months to make a living wall. Now, I know a lot of you are wondering, what in the world is a living wall, right? Well, what it is a nice lush backdrop of trees along our back fence. And it's going to grow in over the next 6 months. It's going to be absolutely beautiful and provide some nice greenery for us back here. So I know a lot of you might be wondering, why aren't you planting fruit trees or something edible? Well, you guys know I have a lot to maintain here in the backyard. We've got tons of edible stuff, and I just didn't have the time or the space or the energy to maintain any fruit trees. So hopefully in the next few years, those will be going in the front yard. Change of plans, that sometimes happens in garden projects. We decided we need more space up against the fence here for our living wall of trees. So we are going to move this planter, relocate the plants, and then later on, after the trees are planted, we'll be relocating the planter somewhere else. So the challenge is gonna be moving the plants. I'm pretty disappointed. These were gonna be my winter tomatoes, but that's the way it goes. Again, you win some, you lose some. Hopefully we can get them transplanted successfully. Good luck, little tomato. Just gonna dig around the roots the best I can, as deep as I can. Try and lift the tomato out very carefully. I think it'll be okay. Oh, that came right out.
The soil's really soft down here.
Yeah, it's nice soil. And I'm just gonna take it right over to the garden bed that we just moved. It's really the only empty spot I have right now. Now this is a squash. This is the one I'm a little worried about. Might not be quite as resilient as the tomato. This one I've got a couple of ripe tomatoes on, so I'm really hoping I can save this plant. It's a Siberian tomato, and it's cold tolerant, so I was really hoping it would last me through the winter. Look at those tomatoes. For now, we'll just put it here. I'd love to save this Mexican sunflower. I absolutely love it. It's so pretty. The bees love it. But I just don't know if a sunflower will survive transplanting or if we can disentangle it from the trellis. But I'm going to give it a go. This one's here hasn't bloomed yet, so I'm going to try first with this one.
Can she do it?
It'd be a miracle if this one makes it. I think I'm gonna have to sacrifice these two branches.
Ouch. Ouch.
You okay?
Yeah, I think it'll grow back.
Are you sad?
I am sad. I love this sunflower. It's so pretty.
Got nothing to lose by trying this.
I know.
Everything to gain.
Bye-bye, sunflower. The kale's gonna go bye-bye, but that's okay. I have a ton of kale, and it grows really fast anyway, so I'll just plant some more seeds.
What the kale?
What the kale.
Remember that video?
Yes.
Three, two, one,
lift.
Clear. Got everything. There you go, nice.
Cool.
So slowly walk over to the strawberry towers.
Relatively painless. I think I can save the dahlias. Getting our workout in today.
Oh,
Can't waste good garden soil. Yeah, it's nice and loose. Man, this is great soil.
How old is it?
Maybe 3 or 4 years. Added lots of compost over the year.
It's gorgeous.
Shredded leaves. This year I added some good dirt, soil conditioner. This is really nice soil. So I really want to hang on to it. We also decided we're going to move this 8-foot Smart Pots raised bed that you saw scooch back from the wall, just to give us some more space also. I've already emptied out most of the plants. I'm going to start on the Smart Pots by removing the drip irrigation. And I think what we're going to do is actually use this one for our fall garden rather than moving the one down on the upper deck that you saw in the fall garden series video last weekend. Since it's already down here, we've emptied it out. Why not, right? One less thing to do. So we've got the 8-foot Smart Pots mostly emptied out with soil. Now we have to attempt to move it across the yard to the other deck. 1, 2, 3, lift.
You good?
We're good.
Okay, lift. Eggs. Swing around.
Go ahead where you think is good. Big day tomorrow. We're going to get the trees installed. We are so excited. This
Very
is
exciting.
Finally coming to the last stretch. So I just want to ask you this because I know you. Right now, this garden is in total disarray. Is it driving you nuts?
It is driving me nuts. There's stuff everywhere. Can't get to my tools. It actually makes me feel kind of anxious when I come out here because it's just all in a big, big mess. I don't like it at all. So I can't wait to get it back into shape and get it back to looking the way I really like it.
I know. I know her, and I know it's been a struggle for her to have this place in such disarray where she can't get to one part of the garden without having to move something or two things in order to get to it. But she's actually done really well for this being in such an upheaval for the past 2 weeks or so.
Oh,
so good job. Tomorrow's a big day.
Tomorrow's a big day. We're excited to finish the project. So we've got another big day ahead of us. Today we want to wrap up the project, finish planting the trees, install some irrigation, cover it with mulch, and make it look beautiful again. We had a 2-foot trench dug along our back fence this week. Several of the trees have been planted, and today we're going to finish it up. The trees that we're planting are called Japanese privets. They're super fast growing, and it's going to be fun to see them fill in.
We actually have these privets up on the main deck. The problem with those is that I tried to prune them, and they're really kind of out of control. I don't really know what I'm doing there. So we're going to bring in some help to help us shape these into a nice living wall.
So let's get them in here. We've got about 3 more to plant. And first thing I'm going to do actually is add some amendment here to our planting hole. So first off, we're going to add the good old compost. So camera guy, why don't you dump a whole bunch of compost right there?
Here?
Right.
Show.
Where your feet are. Now we're going to show this. Okay, that's good, that's good, that's good. Now we're also gonna throw in some of the Vermicera worm castings because the worm castings always make everything better and they're especially good for the root development. And by the way, guys, we just wanna thank Vermicera for such a wonderful product. They're helping us with this project by supplying some of the trees, partnering with us on the video, supplying the castings, and supplying another irrigation product we'll talk about in just a moment.
Okay,
so put like 3 scoops or so in there. So this is exciting. Just gonna set the tree down in the hole here. We're planting these trees about 2 feet apart so they fill in quickly. It's gonna be densely planted and that way it fills in and forms our wall a whole lot quicker. In between each tree, we're putting a special deep watering tube. This is called a Hydra Spiral. It's a brand new product by Vermicera. We're testing it out with our living wall. And the whole idea is that it will deep water the roots. So the roots spread out and the tree is much healthier, much sturdy, has a much better chance for success. So the really cool thing about this is the tube is aerated. So not only does it help the water sink down and get deep into the roots, but it also provides aeration to the roots. And healthy roots mean a healthy tree. So we're gonna sink this down right next to the tree, just a little bit into the ground, and get it as deep as we can go. We are leaving about 4 inches or so sticking up because we're gonna be adding some mulch in here. The cool thing about the Hydra Spirals too is it does have a little filter on the top to help prevent debris from getting into it. The whole idea is I've got my drip irrigation tube running back behind, and I will run a drip emitter over to the tube to help deep water the roots and really spread the water out throughout our trench of living trees. So I'm just gonna place now another tree over here. Okay, camera guy, we got two more to plant. You ready?
Yep.
This is gonna be fun. Our compost, some more worm castings. Pick up some Vermastera products at vermastera.com and make sure to use my code CALLIEKIM for a 10% discount. Okay, camera guy, ready for the tree. Drop down in here right next to the hydro spiral. Looking good.
Wow. I think we're gonna have some excess dirt.
I think we're gonna have some excess dirt, maybe some excess rocks too.
Who needs some? Come get it.
You can help us out while you're at it. We're doing 4 inches because we're gonna add mulch, backfill, and that'll raise the surface up here.
Yep, good to know.
Okay, I need the last tree there. Oops, I forgot to add my compost. Don't want to forget the compost, sorry. Good old homemade compost is gonna make these trees grow really fast too. All right, last one in the ground. Completing the beginning of our living wall. Okay, camera guy, now your job now is to hold the hydro spirals and move the drip out of the way while I backfill here. That way the hydro spiral will stay up nice and straight. So now what I'm gonna do is install my dripper into the hydro spiral. So I'm just poking a hole here in this half inch tube. Make sure you subscribe to our channel and click that bell icon because that's how you get notified when you post an update to our living wall. It's a little bit of water in the tube that's running out. So I've just attached a little quarter inch tube here. I've got a 2 gallon per hour dripper. A little barb connector on the end that should snap right into place here. There we go. I'm gonna put that right into the hydro spiral. And then I'm gonna add some little pebbles in here to help hold the dripper down. And then as we come along and cover this whole area with mulch, it's gonna help hold our half inch tube down and just make this area look really, really pretty.
Kim has turned on the water through the drip irrigation. We're ready for the big test. Let's see how it looks.
This is really cool. Now I see why they call them spirals. Look at this water. It's just spiraling all around the tube, down into the ground. That is pretty cool. So it's soaking that whole ground right underneath it. Time for a lunch break. We're getting tired. It's hot out. We got our strawberry banana smoothies. So refreshing. It's a peanut butter toast. We've got to lay some mulch down now, clean up, and then I think we're done. Camera guy. Okay, so we are laying down some cedar wood chips here, and cedar not only smells super good, but it also is a natural pest repellent. So it's gonna help with the water evaporation over here too. And oh my gosh, I love the smell of these cedar chips. We have them in our walkways and other areas of our yard. It smells so good. Well, camera guy, we did it.
Yeah, we did.
It's a lot of hard work, but we're so excited to see our living wall in. Make sure you guys subscribe so you can follow along as it grows up and covers our whole back fence.
Definitely, it's gonna be really neat to see how these things do. And
it's gonna be so pretty.
Yep.
So I just wanna thank Vermastera for providing some of the trees, for providing the hydro spirals, the worm castings. We'll be watering with worm tea as well. Head to their website, vermastera.com. Use my code CALLIEKIM for a 10% discount.
Cool.
And I hope all you guys are busy planting your fall seeds today while we're out here in the hot sun slaving away. Head to my website, pick up my fall garden seed collection, and comment below. Let us know how things are going in your garden. Thanks so much for watching. We'll see you on the next video. Now it's time to clean up.